Hi everyone, this is Venkatesh Pandyam. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to explain what are the different graphs that we use in physics, what is the purpose of graphs, what graphs give us, and let us see some important graphs in motion straight line. Yeah, so I am trying to give all this information at one particular place so that it will help you, be helpful to you all. Yeah, before I start my lecture, please subscribe my channel. Don't forget to leave your comments at the end of the videos. Share with your friends. And once again, I welcome you all to my channel. Let's see what are the different graphs. Yes, I welcome you all to the world of physics. Yes, today let us understand what is need for graphs. Why we need graphs, first of all? What is that we get from graphs? What information the graphs give us? Let us see. Generally, whenever we draw a graph, we'll have two things. Generally, the graphs are drawn between two variables. We have two types of variables. One is called dependent variable. The second one is called independent variable. One is called dependent, another one is called independent variable. Let's take an example. Suppose if I say y is equal to 2x, if x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4. So from this, it is very clear that the value of y changes whenever x changes. So y is called dependent variable, x is called independent variable. So we take independent variable on x-axis, dependent variable on y-axis. Whenever you draw a graph, this is how we draw. We always draw a graph by taking independent variable on x-axis, dependent variable on y-axis. That's a common thing. So if you plot the graph, as the value of x 0, 1 and 2, if you look at the values of y 2, 0, 2 and 4. So when x is equal to 1, y is 2. When x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4. So this graph is a straight line graph. The shape of the graph depends upon the relation between the variables. Very important point. The shape of the graph depends upon the relation between the variables. All these equations have different shapes depending on the relation. So what is that graph is giving? From this graph, we understand x and y are linearly dependent. What does it mean? As x increases, y is also increasing. Just by looking at the graph, I can say what called as dependency. For example, you will be given a graph like this. Suppose I have a velocity time graph. The velocity time graph is given like this. So what does it mean? From this graph, what is that information we'll get? Let me say. Suppose the shape of the graph is given like this, and some time interval also will be mentioned. So let's take this is 0 second, 5 second, 10 second, 15 and 20. So what we can say from this graph? we can say that a body starts from rest, then moves with uniform acceleration, that is velocity is increasing, then it reaches certain velocity, then from that time, from 0 to 5 seconds, the body is accelerating. From 5 to 10 seconds, the velocity is constant, so body moving with uniform velocity. Then again from 10 to 15 seconds, the body is accelerating. Then from 15 to 20 seconds, the body moving with uniform velocity. Just by looking at the shape of the graph, I am able to describe the motion of the body. So this, from the graph, we'll understand where the body started, how the body is moving, where it is accelerating, where it is moving with uniform velocity, all that we can say. So graphs give us a lot of information about the motion of the body. So let us, before I go to the graphs that are there in motion straight line, we should understand what are the different types of graphs we need in physics. Right. So we have straight line graphs, we have parabola, we have hyperbola, we have a graph in the form of ellipse, all that. So in this, I'm going to just give you an idea about the different graphs. The first one, let us see what is the shape of the graph called y is equal to mx. I said y is dependent variable, x is independent variable. If you draw this y is equal to mx graph, it looks like this. So this is y, this is x. Here this m is called slope. This value m is called slope. This is nothing but theta. So what is tan theta? Tan theta is nothing but actually change in y by x. Or we simply say y by x, which is nothing but m. So y is equal to mx graph is a straight line passing through origin. Now let's go to the second graph. What is y is equal to mx plus c? This c is called y intercept. So what is the shape of this y is equal to mx plus c graph? This is the shape of y is equal to mx plus c graph. So this graph is having positive slope and this is called m intercept. This is again x. This is the shape of y is equal to mx plus c graph. Now let me go to the third one. What is y is equal to mx minus c graph? In this case, the slope is positive, but intercept is negative. So if you look at this graph looks like this. This is y, again this is x. This is theta and this intercept, this from here to here, it is the intercept but is negative. So y is equal to mx minus is a straight line, but it has a negative intercept. Now let us see the fourth graph, y is equal to minus mx plus c graph. So in this case, the slope is positive, so negative, but intercept is positive. So y is equal to mx minus c graph looks like this. So angles measured in clockwise are taken as negative. Measured in anti-clockwise are taken as positive. So here the slope is negative, but intercept is positive. This intercept is positive, but the slope is negative. This is y is equal to minus mx plus c graph. Now I'll draw next graph, that is fifth graph. Y is equal to constant. That means even when x changes, the y value is always a constant. That means this is the shape of y is equal to constant graph. The next one, x is equal to constant. How does it looks? Even when y changes, the value of x is always a constant. This is the shape of x is equal to constant. So these six are the straight line graphs. Y is equal to mx, y is equal to mx plus c, y is equal to mx minus c, y is equal to minus mx plus c, y is equal to constant, x is equal to constant. There is one more variety also we can draw, that is y is equal to minus mx graph. How does that y is equal to minus mx graph looks? It looks like this. Again, it has a negative slope. This is y, this is x, this is theta. So it is measured in anti-clockwise. So these are the seven varieties of straight line graphs. All of these we use in our discussion in physics. Next one, let me teach you. These are very important straight line graphs. Suppose if an equation looks like this, if y is equal to ax square, then if you draw a graph between x and y, so this xy graph is a parabola and we say it is upward parabola. This is upward parabola. So what is the shape of that parabola graph? This is y, this is x. It will look like this. And suppose if y is equal to ax minus bx square, again remember it is a parabola, but it is a downward parabola. Remember, you learn more graphs in mathematics, more graphs in maths. All the shapes will be you learnt in maths. So upward parabola, downward parabola, or we can learn all these graphs in maths. Then we'll discuss. Suppose if we can write like this. Yeah, one more straight line graph we can draw in intercept form. Sometimes the eighth one is also there. X by a plus y by b is equal to 1. This is also straight line. How it looks, let us see. So I'll write y by b is equal to 1 minus x by a. So this nothing but y is equal to minus b by ax plus b. So it is of the form y is equal to minus mx plus c. So this is called intercept. I mean, two intercepts are given. This graph also looks like this. This is y is equal to minus mx plus c. And remember, this is given as a, this is given as b. So this is theta. So what is tan theta? The slope in the place of slope, we have b by a. So tan theta is equal to b by a. These are all the varieties of straight line graphs we discuss. Now, let us move on to the next one. Suppose if x square plus y square is equal to some r square. R is a constant. We say it is a circle. Remember, this is the equation of circle. If you draw a graph between x and y, it is a circle. And this is the radius. And suppose if you take x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Remember, this is the equation of ellipse. This is the equation of ellipse. So how ellipse looks? It looks like this. Here there are two axes, major axis, minor axis. The last variety is, suppose if x, y is equal to constant, the product. That means y inversely proportional to x. If you draw a graph between x and y, this graph looks like this. It is called a rectangular hyperbola. This is called rectangular hyperbola. So these are all the different shape of the graph that we'll discuss in physics, that we use in physics. So we have straight line graphs. Totally, we have discussed nearly 8 varieties of straight line graphs. Then we have seen the equation of parabola, upward parabola, downward parabola. Remember, this is a downward parabola. This represents. Then if x square plus y square is equal to r square, it's a circle. X square by a square plus y square by a square is equal to 1, it is an ellipse. Then if xy is equal to constant, and we call it as a rectangular hyperbola. Now let's see the graphs in motion a straight line. Let us discuss one by one graph here. So first and foremost graphs is position time graph. So that's what I've drawn. How to find the slope here? Just now explain, if it is a straight line, this is theta. So this is change in delta y. This is the change in x, delta x. So tan theta is nothing but opposite side by hypotenuse. So the angle made by the graph with x-axis can be calculated. That's what we discussed here. So tan theta is equal to y2 minus y1 by t2 minus t1, if it is time axis. If generally if it is x and x1, we can write like. So in general, I explain change in x by change in y by change in x. This is the slope. Now let us discuss first one, displacement time graph. The, as I said, the shape of the graph depends upon the equation or motion. First one, initially the body is at rest. When the body is at rest, what is the velocity? Zero. Initially, the velocity of the body is zero. When the velocity is zero, and remember, wherever you see the body is at rest, that means its displacement, what called as velocity of the body is zero. And there are two things here. Yeah, there is a different meaning of it. I'll draw one more first. For this one, the graph looks like this. This is displacement and this is time. Suppose initially the body at the origin, it will continue to be at the same point. Then the body is set to be at rest. Now, what is the meaning of this one? In this case, the body is not at the origin. It has some initial displacement, but still it is at rest. Here, in this case, this S0 is equal to zero. But in this case, the body has some. In both the cases, the body is at rest only. So what is the displacement time graph when the body is at rest? It is a straight line parallel to time axis. What is meant by slope? What is theta here? Angle made by this line with x axis, time axis. So it's a, since it is a parallel line, so theta is equal to zero. Now let us see. Zero initially, yeah, that's what I said. The body has some initial zero displacement. We got this, okay. Now let us see. Zero initial displacement, but body moving with uniform velocity. When I say zero initial displacement, it always starts from origin. Now moving with uniform velocity means, what is uniform velocity? If a body covers equal displacements in equal intervals of time, then the body is said to be moving with uniform velocity. So wherever you see velocity constant, so it is a straight line. We know that V is equal to U plus AT. Here you are saying that, yeah, S is equal to UT plus half a T square, so displacement time graph. So we know S is equal to UT plus half a T square. When the velocity is constant, what is acceleration? Zero. Obviously, S is equal to UT. It is of the form Y is equal to MX. What is the shape of MX? Y is equal to MX graph is a straight line passing through origin. So here, M is equal to tan theta. In the place of M, you have U. That is velocity. So this graph will give you the velocity. Now, this is a very interesting equation we should understand. So from this, we understand the slope of this ST graph. Slope means tan theta. Tan theta is S by T, nothing but velocity. That's what I've written here. So the slope of the graph gives velocity. Slope of the graph gives velocity. Now, sometimes it's given like this. The distance time graph of a particle makes angle theta 1 with the time axis. After T seconds, it makes an angle theta 2 with the time axis. Then the acceleration is, see what happens. Let us take, this is the displacement time graph. S T graph. Initially, it is making an angle theta 1. That means there is a velocity V1. So I can write V1 is equal to tan theta 1. After some time, right, he's saying it is making an angle theta 2 now. When angle changes, velocity also will change V2. So I can write V2 is equal to tan theta 2. Now, what is acceleration definition? Change in velocity by time. So from this, I can write tan theta 2 minus tan theta 1 whole upon t. So from this graph, we can find out acceleration also. Now let's move on to the next graph. Yes, with initial displacement, body moving with uniform velocity, since velocity is uniform, acceleration is zero. What is the difference between the above graph and this graph? In the above graph, the body starts from the origin, so initial displacement is zero. But in this case, the body not starting from origin, it is starting from some other point, so there is an initial displacement S naught, but still it is a straight line. There is a straight line. So, but remember, initial velocity is zero. So we know that S is equal to, since there is some initial displacement S naught plus ut plus half at square, acceleration zero. So it is of the form, or I can write S is equal to ut plus S naught. Ut plus S naught. So y is equal to mx plus c. This is the equation of y is equal to mx plus c. Now, comparison of velocities. As I said in the above case, the displacement time graph, the slope gives velocity. So that's what I've done. So here, this is V1 making an angle theta 1, V2 making an angle theta 2. So I can write V1 is equal to tan theta 1, V2 is equal to tan theta. From the graph, it is clear that theta 2 greater than theta 1. When theta increases, tan value increases. So obviously, tan theta 2 greater than tan theta 1. Therefore, V2 greater than V1. So sometimes they give graphs and you're asked to find out which one is more. Is it V1 or V2? So it is very clear that V2 greater than V1. Now, we have seen that in all these cases, the body is moving with uniform velocity. Now, the next one is body moving with constant acceleration. The body moving with constant acceleration. What happens if the body moves with constant acceleration? Yes, we use the formula. Again, body starting from rest. So, velocity is zero. So, we know the equation ut plus half at square. When t is equal to zero, u zero. So, the equation is half at square. It is of the form y is equal to x square. So, graph is a upward parabola. The graph is an upward parabola. And remember, whenever you want to find out the angle, the direction, simply draw a tangent. If you take any curve, we can draw a tangent. This tangent will give you the direction of velocity. Here the velocity is like this. Here the velocity. That is called instantaneous velocity. That's what I wrote. Slope of the graph gives instantaneous velocity. From this ST graph, we can find out the direction of velocity just by drawing a tangent. So ST graph, when the body moving with uniform acceleration, then it is an upward parabola. Then otherwise, same, the tangent rule I talked about there. Now body moving with retardation now. So when we say retardation, again here u zero only. So S is equal to minus at square. It is of the form y is equal to minus ax square. It is a downward parabola. If it is moving with uniform acceleration, upward parabola. Moving with retardation, downward parabola. Same logic. Now, here it is given that body is, see what is the shape of the ST graph given. What does it mean? Here the body is accelerating for some time, then decelerating for some time. If the shape of the graph is like this, it is accelerating for some time, then decelerating. Body is accelerating and decelerating, then ST graph is like this. Yeah, body is moving with infinite velocity. What does it mean in this case? Angle made is 90 degrees. I said V is equal to tan theta. So nothing but tan 90, nothing but infinity. So this type of graphs are not possible. Then body moving with the constant velocity, but in the opposite direction. That means if you look at the body, if you take one direction as positive, the opposite direction will take the negative. So when the body moves with the uniform velocity, positive velocity, the graph is like this. If it moves with the velocity constant, but in the opposite, we draw a graph like this. So that's why the graph is like this. The slope is negative. That's why we got. And this is the summary of all the graphs that we discussed. See, just by looking at the shape, we can identify. When the first one, if you look at it, is a straight line parallel to time axis. So the body is at rest. So that's what a velocity zero means. Body is at rest. The second one, the ST graph is a straight line. Body moving with uniform velocity or constant velocity. Second one. The third one, upward parabola. Body moving with acceleration. Our velocity increase means acceleration. Body moving with acceleration. Fourth one, retardation. Velocity is decreasing. Retardation. And fifth one, as I said, infinite velocity graph is not possible. Velocity cannot be determined from this graph as it is a infinite graph. Next one, another important one. Now let us draw ST square graph. When a body starts from rest, what is ST square graph? We know that S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Since the body is starting from rest, U0. So what is S then? Half AT square. Remember, this is the difference between ST graph and ST square graph. If I want to draw ST square graph, that means this T square is taken as a single term. So that means S is proportional to T square. That's why it is a straight line. ST square graph, if it is a straight line. And one more important point, what is the slope of this graph? It is of the form, if I draw ST square graph, it is of the form Y is equal to MX. In the place of M, what we have? A by 2. So what is the slope of ST square graph? A by 2. So in the exam, they give ST square graph and they'll ask you what is the slope of that view. Slope is some, for example, they'll give say 60 degrees. So tan 60 is equal to A by 2. We can find out the value of. Similarly, I'm drawing SV square graph. From where I got? We know V square minus U square is equal to S. Again, the body starts from rest. Yes. So U0. V square is equal to 2s. I am taking S and V square. So from this we can say that V square, this is of the form Y is equal to again mx. So I think, sorry, this here it should be V square. This should be S. V square and S. Then only the slope become 2a. If you draw the reverse, if I take here, what is that? If I take S here and V square here, the slope becomes 1 by 2a because in this case, S is equal to 1 by 2a V square. It is of the form Y is equal to MX. So if you draw S V square graph, the slope gives 1 by 2a. If you draw V square S graph, the slope gives 2a. It is S V square graph means here V square is on Y axis, then only this value. If it is SV square graph, EITR, you can change it as 1 by 2A. Either you can write. So these are all the different varieties of displacement, time graph, displacement, velocity graph, all that. Now let us see the next category of graphs, that is velocity time graph. Till now we have discussed only displacement time graph. Now the same logic we'll see velocity time graph. The first one, again, the body moving with uniform velocity. Or we can draw velocity time graph when the body is at rest also. Let me draw that first. What is velocity time graph when the body is at rest? Take V and T. So when the body is at rest, what is the velocity? Zero. This is straight line parallel time axis. when the body is at rest. But this is the graph when the body is moving with uniform velocity. Wherever you see, velocity is constant. Again, what is the slope? Zero. What is the slope of velocity time graph? Velocity by time. So acceleration is zero. When the velocity is constant, acceleration is zero. Now, very important. So that's why it's a straight and part time axis. So it is of the form y is equal to constant. So VT graph gives this, gives the DC. Here, if you look at velocity VT graph, area VT graph gives displacement, and area of this is V bar means magnitude, that is speed time graph gives distance. Area of velocity time graph gives displacement, whereas speed time graph gives distance. So suppose you take this graph, so it is a straight line, and all this is the area below it. So we can find out, if you know the area of this graph, we can find out displacement. Similarly, here also the shape of the graph is like this. The area covered by this, we can find out what called as displacement. All that, this only. We can find out the displacement. This is a very important one. Now you look at the body, motion is given. It is moving with uniform acceleration, then retardation, then it stopped there, then again it moves with uniform velocity, then uniform, what constant velocity, but in the reverse direction. If this is the shape of the graph, how do you calculate distance and displacement? There is a convention. Since displacement is a vector, areas above the time axis are positive, below taken as negative. So that's why when you want to calculate displacement, take above areas positive, below areas negative. That's why I wrote A1 minus A2 plus A3, because above minus A4. And since speed is a scalar, all areas are positive only. Okay, whether you take above or below. So this is the way we find out displacement from velocity time graph, and this is the way we find out distance from velocity time graph. Simply find out the areas, then simply add them along with the symbols for displacement. Don't consider symbols for distance. Then the next one, body moving with constant acceleration. When the body moving with constant acceleration, velocity time graph is a straight line, but again initial velocity is zero. We know V is equal to U plus AT. When U is equal to zero, V is equal to AT. It is of the form Y is equal to MX. So what is tan theta? Tan theta is at slope of this VT graph gives acceleration. Now again, this is just like comparison of velocity. We can compare the velocities just how we compared this, what we called as accelerations. Again, we can write as tan theta is equal to A, and again theta 2 greater than theta 1, tan theta 2 greater than tan theta 1, A2 greater than A1. This is the comparison of accelerations for two graphs. Next one, if there is an initial velocity, so what is the difference between these two? Here initial velocity is zero, here there is initial velocity. So what is the equation? V is equal to U plus AT, or V is equal to AT plus U. It is of the form Y is equal to MX plus C. This is the shape of Y is equal to MX plus C. So there is a slope, and this is the initial velocity. Then the body moving with constant retardation. Constant retardation means the equation becomes like this. V is equal to U minus AT, negative, or V is equal to minus AT plus U. It is of the form minus MX plus. I told you this is the shape of minus MX plus C graph. When the body moves with retardation, this is the shape. Then body moving with increasing acceleration. So when the body moves with acceleration, increasing, it's not constant, then again it is upward parabola. And if it is moving with constant decreasing acceleration, it is a downward parabola. And once again, I summarize the graph. So first graph, velocity is equal to constant. And this is the second graph, acceleration is equal to constant. And fifth graph, what is this? Wherever you see velocity what called as is increasing time, this is not possible. This graph is not possible. Fifth one, not possible. And what about the fourth one? Acceleration is increasing, and third one, sorry, reverse, acceleration is decreasing, and third one, acceleration is increasing, all that. Again, we can draw this velocity displacement graph if initial velocity is zero. So we know the equation v square minus u square is equal to 2s. Since initial velocity is zero, so v square is equal to 2s. Now I'm drawing a graph between v and s. So v and how s proportional to s? S proportional to v square. It is like y is equal to some ax square. Okay. So this is positive, right? So then it is the wrong graph. This should be like this. It's upward parabola. It should be upward parabola because s and v is positive, right? S is a positive. So we have to do body starting from rest, moves along straight line with the constant s. Angle, it should be upward parabola only. It's a parabolic about x axis, so it should be upward. That is wrong actually. Now at last we'll see the third varieties of graphs, that is acceleration time graph. We usually say AT graph. We don't have much acceleration time graphs, only very few. So again, when the body is at rest, say for example, when the body is at rest, no acceleration, acceleration time graph is along time axis. Even when the velocity is constant, acceleration zero, again it is a straight line path. That is the second thing look at. When the acceleration of the body is zero, that means the body moving with uniform velocity. When velocity is constant, acceleration is zero, it is a straight line parallel time axis. If the body moves with constant acceleration, so it is a straight line parallel time axis. If the body moves with retardation, constant retardation, so then we draw it in the below time axis. This is it. If the acceleration is constant, if the retardation is constant, this is the shape. And again, what does this area of the graph? What is the area? This is very important. AT graph, acceleration variable. Remember, this is a very important point you should remember, especially this one. The area of AT graph gives change in velocity. Why? Because acceleration is V minus U by T. So AT is equal to V minus. The product of Y and X, the product is called area. This is area. So what is the area of gives change in velocity? Some students say that it gives velocity. No, it is actually it gives change in velocity. The area of acceleration time graph gives change in velocity. Area of velocity time graph gives displacement. Okay. Similarly, if the body acceleration is increasing, upward parabola, angle decreasing, downward parabola. There is one more graph we want to draw. This is AX graph. We know this formula, V square minus U square equal to 2AS. So what is this AS? V square minus U square by 2. So what is the area of AS graph gives? Very, very important. It will give you V square minus U square by 2. The area of AS graph, sorry, this is not AT, this is AS. The area of AS or AX we can take, that will give you V square minus U square. So these things you should remember. Area of AS graph is V square minus U square. Area of AT graph is V minus U. Let me summarize all these points once. The first and foremost point is slope of ST graph. Slope of ST graph gives velocity. Second one, slope of VT graph gives acceleration. Third one, area of VT graph gives displacement. Next, area of AT graph, acceleration time graph, gives change in velocity, v minus u. And the fifth one, area of AS graph. Area of AS graph gives v square minus u square by 2a. These 5 points are very, very important that you should remember from the graphs. Now, at last, let's see how to, sometime they'll ask you the comparison between the graphs. Let us see the conversion. So all these are already I've drawn in the above. See, when displacement is constant, initial velocity is zero, so angle is zero. What is the shape of ST graph? This is the ST graph. But displacement is, it has some value, it is constant. When the displacement is constant, what is velocity? Zero. That's why VT graph is like this. Obviously, when velocity is zero, what is aggression? Zero only. So when the displacement time graph is of this shape, then automatically this is the shape of velocity time graph. This is the shape of AT graph. Now next one. S is increasing, that is velocity is. So ST graph is a straight line, means velocity is equal to constant. Remember, in this case, velocity is zero. When velocity constant, what is ST graph? VT graph, straight line parallel time axis. When velocity is constant, what is acceleration? Hence the graph is like this. Very important. So here again, you could have acceleration is zero. Here acceleration zero is right. Now the next one, here S is decrease. That means in this case, displacement is decrease means negative velocity. Velocity is constant but negative. So that's why we are getting a line downward. Again, acceleration in this case, zero. Why? Because velocity is constant. Next, V is increasing at a constant rate. So ST graph, as V is increasing, velocity is increasing. V is increasing at a constant rate, A is positive and constant. So you take S is equal to half a T square graph, then automatically Y is equal to mx minus C graph. So because V is equal to, this is AT minus U, because acceleration is positive, saying acceleration is positive and V is negative. And in this case, acceleration is constant. That's why the graph is a straight line. So like this, they'll give one variety of graph. We can convert other varieties of graph. These are also other way. And at last, remember, as I said, this type of graphs are not possible. Why this is not possible? If you look at one particular time instant, the displacements are different. A body cannot have different displacements at same time. So this is not possible. This graph is not possible. Similarly, I said in this case, what is slope? Acceleration is infinity. This is also not possible. These graphs are not possible. Sometimes in the exam, they'll give you which of the following graphs are not possible. So these are all the graphs you should remember in motion in straight line. So today in this video, we learned why we should learn the graphs, how the graphs help you to understand the motion of the body. Then I told you what is dependent variable, independent variable, where independent is taken, where dependent is taken. Then I explained what are the different straight line graphs. Then I explained what is the equation of a circle, equation of parabola, equation of hyperbola, ellipse, all that. Then we discussed about the ST graph. Then we discussed about VT graph. Then we discussed about AT graph. Then at last we have seen the conversion of these graphs. When one graph is given, how to convert other graph. Then at last we have seen which of the graphs are not possible. So this is all about graphs. So I have given you everything at one place in one video. So definitely to help you a lot to understand the graphs in motion in a straight line. In my next lecture, I'm going to explain some problems based on this graphs. Thank you once again for listening. And again, please subscribe my channel if you really like my content, and leave your comments on every video, and please share with your friends. And once again, thank you all. happy physics learning. Thank you all.
Thanks for watching my videos. Please subscribe my videos and leave your comments. If you like my videos, please share with your friends. Thank you once again.